While synods may be Pope Francis' major tool for the reform of the church, according to Sister Nathalie Becquart, he is also using them to gradually build consensus and preserve its unity. Becquart was an auditor for last October's Synod of Bishops on Young People, Faith and Vocational Discernment, and last May the Pope named her, along with three other women, as consultors to the Synod's General Secretariat, marking a historic first for the Church. While in Rome, for the final days of the Synod on the Amazon, Becquart told Cruz that she sees a strong link between two synods linked by the topic of enculturation. During the Synod of the Youth, the main topic was the question of the enculturation of the gospel in the culture of the youth, and that was also the main topic for the Amazon people, she said. Further, she said, enculturation necessitates another major aspect of synodality, which is vesting local churches with more decision-making power. When you speak about enculturation, you speak about decentralization, and that's the main thing also for the reform of the church nowadays, she added. Becquart, who is a member of the Congregation of Saviors, was the first woman to serve as the director of the National Service for Youth Evangelization and Vocations in France, a post she completed just before arriving in Rome to participate in the last year's synod. Of the last year's summit, she believes that the church is now in the main stage for the reception of the synod, and it's a long process. She recalled a recent conversation with a longtime member of the General Secretariat who told her that receptions of synod often take 10 to 15 years. We are still at the beginning, she said. While she says that the last year's auditors are still on a WhatsApp channel and exchange near daily messages and is quick to point to regional events and initiatives taking place in Lebanon, Vietnam and England as proof that the synod is taking hold on local level, she also wants to remind folk that a synod's outcome document in last year's case, France's apostolic exhortation, Christus Vivit, which he issued in March, is only a starting point. International Dusk, Christian Times.